Well, the fight for Indian culture and the education system has taken a new turn in Gujarat, where new school textbooks talk about shunning Western culture, wearing desi clothes and doing gau seva. The books, mostly authored by Dinanath Batra, the convener of an RSS-affiliated group, also talks about cars in Vedic times. And academics, in fact, have attacked this, calling it a distortion of history. But Mr. Batra says that this is fact.
Don't blow out candles on your birthday. It's Western culture and needs to be shunned. Instead, wear Swadeshi clothes and on that day, do a havan and feed cows. America wants to take credit for invention of stem cell research, but the truth is that India's Dr. Balakrishna Ganpat Mathapurkar has already got a patent for regenerating body parts. Motor cars existed during the Vedic period. It was called the Anashwarath, which used to run without horses. Drawing a map of India? Make sure you include Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, Tibet and Myanmar. These are part of undivided India or Akhanda Bharat. These are some of the lessons from a set of 9 books which the Gujarat Textbook Board wants over 40,000 students to read. And the contents have created a storm. 8 of the 9 books are written by head of Shiksha Bachao Andolan Samiti, Dinanath Batra, who defends his interpretation of Indian history.
They should devise such books which are for character building. These books, which are on the boards, are NCRT. They mislead the boys. Rana Pratap gets only 2 lines and Akbar 2 pages. What is this?
This circular sent out last month tells schools these books will be distributed free of cost and should be made part of supplementary literature.
एक से वो लाइब्रेरी कर रहे रहेगा और उसको टीचर्स लोग कभी कभी पढ़ेंगे वो कंपलसन नहीं है.
The translated version of these books were released by the state education minister Bhupendra Singh Chudasma on 4th of March before this circular was issued to the schools. The minister refused to talk on camera about the issue, but off-camera insisted that there was nothing controversial in these books.
But the Congress says this is an attempt to saffronize education.
Nagpur agenda aur RSS ki yahi soch hai. Aane wali pedhi ko apni soch thopne ja rahe.
Adhyatmik sanskritik jo varsa hai, virasat hai. Wo virasat jo hai wo bacche ke dilo dimag ke andar pade.
Schools are expected to receive these books shortly and the debate is far from over. In Ahmedabad, Rohit Ban for NDTV.
Well, is this an attempt to saffronize education, as the Congress puts it? Is this an attempt to influence young minds, as activists and academics say? Or is this indeed the way Indian history and culture should be interpreted, as Professor Dinanath Batra and the Gujarat government say? Well, joining us in this segment, we have Mr. Dinanath Batra joining us tonight from Delhi. Also, Malika Sarabhai joins us tonight from Ahmedabad. Mr. Batra, I hope you can hear me, sir. My first question to you is, you know, when I read some of the things that are there in the textbook, sir, it's very, very hard to understand, you know, where this has come from. You've written about things like television in the age of the Mahabharat, cars in Vedic times. You've talked about not blowing out candles because it's Western culture, calling professors Acharya. You seem to have a very narrow interpretation, sir, of what Indian culture is, if I may say so, Mr. Batra.
ये जो आपने कहा है ये मेरी पुस्तक का भाग नहीं है. ये पुस्तक मैंने नहीं लिखी है और फिर भी मैं कुछ आपके प्रश्नों का उत्तर देता हूँ. आपने ये कहा है, मेरे से पूछा है कि जो हम जन्मदिन मनाते हैं उन जन्मदिनों पर हमें स्वदेशी वस्त्र धारण करने चाहिए और स्वदेशी ढंग से भारत के आधार पर, भारत की संस्कृति के आधार पर हमें जन्मदिन मनाना चाहिए. मैंने जो कहा है वो ये कि ये जो जन्मदिन है ये इसको हम दान दीप दिवस कहते हैं. इस दिन दीपक जलाना चाहिए. ये तो नहीं है कि मोमबत्तियां बुझानी चाहिए. ये अंधकार करने का दिन है या प्रकाश करने का दिन है. और साथ में ये भी कहा है कि बच्चे जो हैं जिसका जन्मदिन है उसके परिवार के लोग सब मिलकर के झुग्गी झोंपड़ी में जाएं और वहां पर जो उनकी कमाई है, जो उनके पास धन है और जो भी इस प्रकार से सुख है वे बच्चों के साथ वो शेयर करें. इट इज सेंस ऑफ शेयरिंग. तो ये दिन सेंस ऑफ शेयरिंग का है. और प्रकाश करने का दिन है। और दूसरी बात आपने पूछी है कि जो इस प्रकार से अखंड भारत, वे अखंड भारत ज्योग्राफिकल नहीं है, ये तो वास्तव में सांस्कृतिक भारत की बात है। इन सारे ही स्थानों का, देशों का जो आप नाम लेते हैं, यहाँ पर महात्मा बुद्ध की संस्कृति, उनका प्रचार गया था और वे सब लोग बुद्ध को स्वीकार करते हैं। आज इस देश के अंतर्गत भी बुद्ध और भारत मैत्री संघ बन रहा है और गोष्ठियां होती हैं, पुस्तकें लिखी जा रही हैं। अगर इस प्रकार की मैत्री बढ़ती है धर्म के आधार पर, मजहब के आधार पर, बुद्ध और भारत की संस्कृति के आधार पर, तो निश्चय ही जो पड़ोसी हमारे देश हैं उनमें मैत्री बढ़ेगी, प्यार बढ़ेगा, स्नेह बढ़ेगा और वो एक दूसरे के साथ सुख से रहेंगे।
लेकिन बत्रा जी, मुझे नहीं लगता है कि अगर आप इन देशों से पूछेंगे तो उनका प्यार बढ़ेगा हमारे लिए। आप अगर अखंड भारत की बात करेंगे तो मुझे नहीं लगता है दे विल टेक टू दिस वेरी काइंडली। लेकिन ये जो पुस्तकें हैं, मैं पुस्तक वर्ड इसलिए यूज कर रही हूं क्योंकि मैंने पढ़ा है कि आपको यू आर ऑल्सो ऑब्जेक्टिंग टू द यूज ऑफ उर्दू वर्ड्स। लाइक आपने कहीं कहा है शायद टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया में कि जो उर्दू प्रश्न है वो नहीं यूज करने चाहिए, जैसे कि किताब, सो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम यूजिंग द वर्ड पुस्तक। लेकिन क्या आप मानते हैं कि वैदिक पीरियड में भी मोटर कार होती थी और टेलीविजन जो है इट वॉज इन्वेंटेड ड्यूरिंग द एज ऑफ द महाभारत? आप ये बच्चों को पढ़ा रहे हैं, वो आपका जो एक व्यू है दैट इज डिफरेंट बत्रा जी, लेकिन बच्चों को आप कुछ सिखा रहे हैं और एंड दैट शुड बी एज क्लोज टू द ट्रूथ एज पॉसिबल।
आप भी सत्य की बात करिए। मैंने पहले ही आपको कहा है कि ये पुस्तक मेरी नहीं है जिसको आप कोट कर रहे हैं।
ये उन नौ पुस्तकों में से है जो अभी बच्चों को दी जा रही है। आपकी आठ है, ये दिस इज द नाइन्थ बुक, बट क्या आप इससे सहमत हैं?
ये मुझे पता ही नहीं है, मैंने पढ़ी नहीं है, मैंने देखी नहीं है, मुझे तो अपनी पुस्तकों का पता है।
लेट मी टेक दिस टू मालिका साराभाई। मालिका साराभाई, डू यू बिलीव that the problem here is that Mr. Batra is, you know, he has a certain point of view on what Indian history and what Indian culture is, and I think he's entitled to that. It may seem very narrow-minded to the rest of us, but I think the problem arises when a state government endorses that and says that these are now going to be taught in schools where these books will be given, you know, free of cost to more than 40,000 kids.
Nidhi, I haven't read the books myself. I am also going by all the newspapers that have quoted the books. I want to put two things to you about the books before I go on to the state government. One is, one of the quotes is that Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan was dining at an American or English household, and when the host said that we are much loved by God, Sarvapalli Radhakrishnan, according to this book, said, you know, God once wanted to make a chapati and the first one came out raw and that was born the white race. The other one came out burnt and thus was born the Negro. And then God finally got the chapati right and thus the Indian race is the perfect race. Now, I have read a lot of Radhakrishnan and I find it completely inconceivable that Radhakrishnan should speak so crassly. The second one is attributed to Vivekananda, who when he went abroad to lecture, apparently spoke about wearing Indian clothes. And a woman noticed that his shoes were foreign made and said, yes, Swamiji, but your shoes are foreign made. And Vivekananda, according to this book, is quoted as saying, yes, that is where we feel we want to keep all foreigners. Now, it is just inconceivable that either of these could be true. And this is not even going into the gross misrepresentation of science. Forget saffronization. Are we going to bring up a whole generation of idiots?
Good question. I'll take that to Sambit Patra. Sambit Patra, should these books have been part of the Gujarat state curriculum at all? Should they be?
Yesterday I had spoken to Mr. Chudasma, who is the education minister of Gujarat, and he, in fact, not only to me but in all the channels, wherever he was asked, he has denied that this is a part of a syllabus. This is not a part of a syllabus. These are just reference books kept in libraries. So I believe this issue has to be brought in very vehemently, that these are not included in syllabus. Secondly, and most importantly, as most of us, I have also not gone through the book, so whatever little I derive, I would stand by a few and I would deny a few. In the sense, I do not believe that blowing a candle and cutting a cake would do away with our Indianness in our birthday. But well, yes, I would stand by the fact fact that if we get up in the morning in our birthday and we salute our parents, and if we go and share our happiness with the kids around, and if we say namaste to a gau mata, and if we wear Swadeshi clothes, that's going to take away the Indianness of us, or that's going to make us idiots, as Mallika was trying to say it to us. I believe this is what Indianness is all about: caring, sharing, loving all. And about, as far as Swadeshi is concerned, Mahatma Gandhi all his life spoke of Swadeshi. He himself wore Swadeshi.
Motor cars in the Vedic period.
Does that sound plausible? Motor cars in Vedic period and great immense of power and knowledge during the Vedic period. I would say, I would not define the specificities, but I would say, well, yes, we were an extremely developed civilization. And the kind of, no, we were. And see, most of us on the panel, why most of us? Mallika, just a second, I was not interrupting. Mallika, and Nidhi, this is a very serious and a mature issue. Yeah. Let me please complete, and then you can all pounce on me.
You missed 14.
Mallika, just a second. Let me complete.
I'll come back to you, Mallika. Give me a second.
I believe, we are all Indians on the panels, and I think we should have been very happy when it is said that we had a fantastic civilization way back when most of the world did not exist. And if it's said that
Which invented the car?
I would not go into the specificities.
Or the television.
But I would not go into the specifics. But the most important
issue. Because the specifics
are important. Vedic period and the Mahabharata Kala definitely had something which was great deal for us. I believe we should cherish all that.
Even
if he rides a car, for instance, let's assume that he rides a car and a plane existed during Mahabharata time, and there was a television which Sanjay was watching everything that was happening in the Mahabharata ground. I mean, the kind of confidence, the kind of love for the civilization that a child inculcates within himself, I think that is tremendous. Well, yes, if a book would have written that fidelity is of no importance, if a book would have written that, well, yes, you should go and have drugs, I believe we should have objected to it. But a book which tries to instill some kind of civilizational value in you,
okay,
if it is a reference book, what's the problem?
We're using words like Negro.
No, I object to such words.
People are made of rotis. Let's not call anyone professor, let's say Acharya. Let me just bring Abhishek Singhvi and Pawan Verma into this. Abhishek Singhvi first.
Nidhi, I think the first and the basic point we are missing is we are talking of impressionable young minds. We are talking of people, children who are going to read things which range from Akhand Bharat to television to rockets. Now, we are all proud Indians and we believe very strongly in the ancient 5,000, 7,000 year culture of this country, of which the Hindu stream of thought and philosophy is a very important part, but is part of a larger syncretic culture. But that does not mean that the fundamental creed of education, which is to develop a inquiring, rational, logical, questioning mind, is given the go-by, and you are taught things about television and rockets in ancient India. That can be part of a historical narrative in a mythological sense. Secondly, I find it very interesting, you flit like a butterfly, sting like a bee. When it comes to pinpointing, you say it is not been prescribed, but still 40,000 books have suddenly been bought and supplied to students all over and has been kept as library reference books. Obviously, there is a certain amount of subterfuge going on here, possibly not prescribed in a syllabus sense, but people are being encouraged to read it. They are being kept there. Thirdly, we are very proud again of the Bodh culture. That is the pride we have when we have a Buddha trail near Varanasi and Sarnath. That is when the Japanese come and invest in it. But is this the same thing as saying that we should only refer from Thailand to Afghanistan as Akhand Bharat? Are we to ignore the realities of geographical boundaries? So I think, you know, there is a problem here because they're talking of impressionable young minds. I'm even prepared to go to this extent. You can have a total separation when you say this is fact and this is being taught as a story or a mythology. But okay, then you must teach it in a syncretic, inclusive, pluralistic manner. Not the kind of thing I've just heard in your program, in fact. The kind of examples. How can anybody, is it not axiomatic, Nidhi, that if on my birthday I go and do charity, how can anybody object? How is it possible to object to something positive like touching your parents' feet or being respectful? These are axiomatic. This is not a question of Hinduism, non-Hinduism, India, what?
No, my question is whether it is, I mean, like I said, everyone is entitled to their point of view, and I think what anyone says about, you know, having pride in one civilization is important. I think the question is, like you said, impressionable young minds, and, you know, where is fantasy and where is reality? Pawan Verma, weigh in on this. Where do the two meet?
No, Nidhi, let me first say कि मैं बाट्रा जी से सहमत हूँ. I am in agreement with him that there is much that is sterilely anglicized in a certain elite in our country which needs interrogation, which is a blind mimicking of what is done in the West and a rootlessness in our own culture. Let's accept it. What is the problem with Professor Batra? I have written a book on whether how we need to become Indian, the unfinished revolution of culture and identity. I have two problems. One is that he is unacceptably prescriptive. He says, this is the truth, you must believe it, if you have to be an Indian, and even more if you have to be a Hindu. That goes directly against the eclectic spirit of Hinduism and does a great disservice to the glorious legacy of Hinduism, which has not one but six systems of philosophy, including one which is the Charvak school, which says there is no God. Shankaracharya says, na dharmo, na charto, na kamo, na moksha. None of them exist, only Chidananda Rupa Shivoham Shivoham. So let us not reduce Hinduism in a manner by which it becomes a set of didactic, unchangeable beliefs as dictated by people with narrow minds who tell us, this is what you should wear, this is what you should believe, this is how you should eat, this is what you should eat, this is how you should interact with others. This is not our tradition. Let us be good human beings and let us have our confidence
okay,
in ourselves.
Okay, I'm going to take that to Professor Batra. Professor Batra, I think what Pawan Verma said is a very important point, that you seem to believe that the only way to be Indian and to be Hindu in particular is your way, not anyone else's way.
सबसे पहले तो मैं उस प्रश्न का उत्तर देना चाहता हूं कि प्रोफेसर और आचार्य में क्या अंतर है. यह मैं नहीं कह रहा हूं, यह विनोबा जी कहते हैं कि जो शिक्षा क्षेत्र में ये शब्द प्रयोग किया जा रहा है, टीचर, रीडर, लेक्चरर और प्रोफेसर, इन भोंदे शब्दों से जितनी जल्दी हम छुटकारा पा लेंगे तो अच्छा है. प्रोफेसर इज ए पर्सन हु पोजेसेज बट नेवर प्रैक्टिसेज. हम आचार्य कुल के ही सब शिक्षा क्षेत्र के व्यक्ति हैं, क्योंकि हम अपने आचरण से बच्चों को शिक्षा देते हैं. हमारे जीवन के पुस्तक खुले हुए पुस्तक है जिससे बच्चे सीखते हैं. इसलिए आचार्य शब्द का प्रयोग बहुत ही बलपूर्वक विनोबा जी ने किया है, उसी बात को मैंने दोहराया है. दूसरी बात, ये हिंदुइज्म कभी ये नहीं कहता कि किसी एक रास्ते से चलो. हिंदुइज्म ये कहता है, सत्यम एक विप्रा बहुधा वदन्ति, सत्य एक है लेकिन विद्वान लोग, अच्छे लोग, समझदार लोग उसे अनेक ढंग से कहते हैं. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ये कहता है कि जो हमारा मजहब है, इट इज वे ऑफ वर्शिप, ये तो रिलीजन है, लेकिन धर्म है, इसका इक्वलेंट शब्द कोई भी संसार में नहीं है, ये केवल भारत का शब्द है. और इसको सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने कहा है, इट इज वे ऑफ लाइफ, आप जीवन जीने का ढंग ऐसा बनाइए जैसे कि दूसरे की भावनाओं को कष्ट नहीं पहुंचे. हिंदुइज्म ये है जिसको गोस्वामी तुलसीदास जी ने कहा है कि जो सब लोग हैं, सर्वहित जो करता है वही वास्तव में
लेकिन धार्मिक है. Whether you like it or not, this is a country that has been influenced by many other cultures and civilizations. It's part of, I mean, even British rule is a part of our history. We speak English today because that is who we are.
British rule is, may or may not be Nidhi, but no. Certainly our period of ancient history had great achievements. But to only extol that
is what I'm
saying. Forget a millennia of history is a form of communalism.
I also want to ask Mr. Batra, is it true that you had made a list of words, English and Urdu words that you had a problem with, such as mushkil, dost, gussa, shararat, khabardar. Kya aapko lagta hai ki Urdu shabd istemal nahi hone chahiye? Maine to abhi bahut sare use kiye hain.
Aap jo hai baat ko bahut hi adhura keh rahe hain. Jo Hindi ke pustake hain NCERT ki, kya kabhi aapne suna hai ki Hindi ke pustakon mein angrezi ki kavita honi chahiye? हिंदी के पुस्तक में अंग्रेजी की कविता है. साथ में क्या ये भी आपने सुना है कि 7 फारसी के शेर हैं, 7 कपलेट्स ऑफ पर्शियन. क्या कभी आपने सुना है कि जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में शब्द हैं जिनका प्रयोग करना जुर्म है, यहाँ पर ये शब्द प्रयोग किए गए हैं, और इसके साथ साथ गालियों का प्रयोग किया ये सब हिंदी के शब्द हैं, उसके साथ ही मैंने कहा है कि फारसी के अंग्रेजी के ये शब्द प्रयोग नहीं करने चाहिए, हिंदी को हिंदी रहने दीजिए। कोई अध्यापक पढ़ा ही नहीं सकेगा फारसी के शेरों को, अंग्रेजी की कविता नहीं पढ़ा सकेगा जो कि आपने प्राइमरी क्लास में हिंदी के किताब में लगा दी है। अधूरी बात मत कहिए, पूरी बात यह है कि वहां पर किताब को सुधार करने की बहुत आवश्यकता है, भाषा को सुसंस्कृत बनाने की आवश्यकता है, श्रेष्ठ बनाने की आवश्यकता है। हिंदी के पुस्तकों को पढ़ने के बाद
जो आपका रास्ता है वही एक रास्ता है, जो आपका इंटरप्रिटेशन है वही एक इंटरप्रिटेशन है।
मैंने तो एक ही बात कही, मैं भारतीय हूं और मैं सब रास्तों को ठीक मानता हूं और मैं कहता हूं जिधर से भी आना है, भगवान कृष्ण गीता में कहते हैं उधर से आइए, लेकिन ठीक ढंग से आइए, मैं आपके लिए खड़ा हूं, जिधर से भी आना चाहते हैं आइए। तो ये जब हमारी सोच है तो मैं ये क्यों कहूंगा कि मेरा रास्ता ठीक है, मेरा रास्ता ठीक नहीं है। लेकिन जो शिक्षाविद कहते हैं, क्या ये मुझे कोई भी आम से बैठा हुआ बता सकता है कि हिंदी की पुस्तकों में फारसी के शेर होने चाहिए? 7 शेर हैं फारसी के, कोई बता सकता है? ये तो मैं कहूंगा कि नहीं होना चाहिए।